Hi everyone, feel warmly welcome to Usitility. Do you know what? We are going to see how to run Sakura School Simulator on PC. As you can see now, you are able to watch it on your screen. We will be able to effortlessly download and install Sakura School Simulator and play this game on a Windows PC using our keyboard, mouse and big screen. Then without further ado, let's go my friends. Before anything else folks, to start we need to open our favorite browser. We have here the one we use by default. Let's continue, going to this URL I have highlighted in green. There you are seeing it on the screen. There is no need to type anything, simply because I provided the link in the video description in the first main comment. We arrived right here on the site of Usitility, where we have a nice in-depth explanation on the best way to download and install Sakura School Simulator on laptop or computer. We browse down a little bit and then click on the Download Game on PC button. Once clicking on the link, we reach the site of LDPlayer, which the Android emulator that we will run to get access to the game Sakura School Simulator on the PC. As you can discover from here, we get several advantages of running this emulator: custom controls, multiple instances, instant synchronization, macros, scripts, high FPS, and so on. Then, we will start downloading the Sakura School Simulator by simply clicking on the button Download Sakura School Simulator on PC that you can visualize here in green. Next step is clicking on it. Of course, the download takes no time at all. Voila, this is the download. It's a file to execute. What we have to do is to run the executable file. Okay, so we need to click on the file. Windows 10 users will be asked for permission to make modifications to the laptop or device. We have said yes. I reduced the browser to find the installation software better. The installation software is really simple. It contains a couple of options: install and setup path. I am going to describe what setup path really does. We basically just simply click on it. And then we observe that we end up with here the path where the emulator will be put in. If we need to modify this folder, we are required to click on that browse button. Therefore we choose another directory and install the emulator where we wish. I will keep it by default. Then, I click on back. And therefore I simply click on install. At this point, before starting installing this emulator, it is possible that it'll present us a number of application software packages to put on our desktop or laptop. As I do not need any of these software, I only click many times on the reject button. Great. The installation begins and it is going to proceed together with the download of those megabytes that happens to be visible on our screen. The time you download it, it could possibly be a little more or less megabytes. The download rate might go faster or slower, subject to your internet and depending on the data transfer rate of the emulator servers. Right now they're working superbly fast. The download is done, and at present it continues on with the installation step. The installation will require a little bit more or less time, primarily based on the strength of your personal computer. The more efficient it is, the shorter the setup time and vice versa. If we put together the download and setup step, it can take a very long time, so be patient. It has now finished on my side. At this point, the emulator has been started successfully. As you will notice, down here, there's a progress bar which will fill up when it actually reaches the end. The emulator is started for the first time. The reality is the emulator has already been started, there for the first time. Not to mention LD Store is automatically started, which is actually a kind of Google Play. It's not the optimal method to set up the video game, and I also tend not to advise using it, simply because typically the LD Store sets up an outdated version of the Android game. I am going to tell you how to set up the game using the Google Play. I recommend you to do it this way. First of all, we are required to make is to visit desktop by simply clicking this icon that I am indicating in green color. Before we continue on, as you can discover, it has made a couple of icons right here on the PC desktop. The LD Player and LD Multiplayer. Note that the LD Player icon is going to be the only one we're focused on. At any time when we want to operate Sakura School Simulator on our PC, we twice click this particular icon and consequently launch the emulator. The LD Multiplayer app icon has nothing to do with multiplayer or anything at all like this. Indeed, it's an software icon that we would almost certainly never ever use. We should do the following step, which is actually a must, and that's to begin browsing the Google Play Store. To achieve this, we will go here to System Apps, we click on, and we'll click on Play Store. As you will notice, the Google Play is launched. At this point we are required to sign in. Right now when we're on this page, we must begin doing the next step that is definitely absolutely mandatory. Therefore simply click on Sign In. At this point it says Checking Info. It could once in a while get stuck in Checking Info, and so it doesn't move ahead. In that case, you can attempt to connect to your account after a few hours, but it will surely most certainly be repaired. At this point we will provide our email address and password. The email needs to be a Gmail email as well as its associated password. As an example, you could use the same exact email you use at the moment in your YouTube account. Thus I am going to provide my data and I'll come back as soon as I have accomplished it. That's all, data typed in. Discover Google welcoming us and offering us the terms of service. We will say yes to them all by just hitting, I agree. After that, it offers us to save to the Google Cloud. You can also leave it checked and it'll produce a backup of your data files on this device to Google Drive. I will not check it, you do what you want. We simply click on accept. From now Google Play is launched by default and instantly. If the Google Play isn't started immediately and you are unsure how to start it by yourself, I explain to you how to do it now. The first thing is to head to the emulator desktop by pressing this icon designated in green. Right now we go to the system apps folder. And we click the Play Store icon. Well, we're right here into Google Play. What we're going to accomplish will be go here to search for apps and games. And we're going to locate Sakura School Simulator. So there we have it, we can select the first result. At this point we get the game app. Let's click there on the install option that I am presenting now in green color. This will begin the software installation. Straight away it will download on your desktop or laptop and set up the video game. It typically takes a bit of time, or perhaps it might possibly be almost immediate. It all is going to depend on the internet connection. It's actually completed installing. Back to the emulator desktop by hitting this specific option that I am presenting in green, to be able to run Sakura School Simulator for the very first time. I am by now on the emulator desktop, and so we are going to mouse click on that new Sakura School Simulator software icon which was provided. That game is started for the first time on your computer. There we get it, I'm able to click anywhere on the screen and also make use of the keyboard. I am going to comment on the volume level of that emulator. It is here, we have got the icon of higher volume and also the icon of lower volume. This manner we don't use the Windows volume to increase or decrease the sound experience of the emulator. As well as to enjoy the experience to the maximum, we will turn on the big screen, for which we have two options. That is the first one, we mouse click on this software icon that I'm designating in green color. Then the screen is maximized, offering one border at the top, one at the right and one at the bottom. In the case that we desire to run the application in full screen, we hit this particular app icon. And we'd presently be experiencing and enjoying the game in full screen setting. To leave the complete screen functionality, just click the F11 key. So we would likely now play in normal computer screen mode. From now, I am starting to demonstrate you the computer keys mapping, which is really extremely exciting. That step we will probably be capable to play the game much more easily. The first point is to click this computer keyboard icon. And right now there you will be able to get the recommended configurations. I'm going to keep the default settings, though if you require to modify this, you can do it now with no problem. I take on this chance to say that once in a while, when starting the game app a black screen shows up. If it's so and you get the black screen and that emulator does not commence, I propose a possible alternative. We should go here, to the cogwheel. Inside the emulator options, in the advanced choice we have now several resolutions. That is the resolution we've previously opted for as favorite choice, and so we should select any of these other resolutions, for example that one down below. We opt for it and click on save. It will require us to restart this emulator, and immediately after rebooted, likely the emulator will commence and your black screen will cease to exist. Obviously, the emulator is totally in our own language. Once in a while it happens that the emulator is started in the incorrect language, such as, in Mandarin. So to set it in the proper language we go there to the cogwheel. So here inside of many other settings, we just click on the language drop down. We may opt for the language we need, German, Mandarin, and so on. As soon as the language is chosen, we should save, the emulator would restart, and also the video game, the next time we launch it, will also be in the selected language. At this time, there is another information that we have to take into account, and it's that we will receive a message from Gmail telling you that a different electronic device has been linked to this Google account. It will question us if we are the ones who have associated with that device. Of course, we should not be troubled, because the emulator is emulating in Google Android electronic device. And then to discover which smartphone or tablet is currently being emulated, we come here, to the cogwheel and we simply click on it. Be sure to go here to the model choice. And now we see that the emulator is acting as a Samsung mobile phone. And so we're going to receive an email saying that a new Samsung device has been connected to our Google account. This is it folks, so much for our video user demo. I hope you enjoyed it, particularly that you thought it was interesting. If that's so, offer it a pleasant like, subscribe, and I will be happy to answer your comments, issues or suggestions, let them in the comment box down below. You can also leave a comment on my Twitch channel, I actually do live streams every once in a while, you get it listed below in the video description and in the first pinned comment. Check out any of these training videos that are appearing on the computer screen and see you in the following video tutorials. Bye.